What is going on, guys? Spiteful is back again, coming at you with a brief tutorial guide, sort of. I don't want to go too deep into this, but I do want to go over and point out a few things, especially for beginners. Now, when you're looking for a character that's good in co-op raids and whatnot, you're going to want to look for characters with high bruiser, such as White Zangetsu, which is new. Uryu's pretty good as well. You're going to want to look for characters with frenzy. Let me just go into this. Yeah, so characters with frenzy, strong attack recharge time are very good for raids in general. You're going to want to have, if you're going to go the NAD build, I highly recommend that you're used to the character, like incredibly used to the character, because co-op raids are kind of annoying in the sense that the bosses don't get staggered, and that's a very big issue, especially for newer players who are trying to understand the mechanics. You can't just, in single player, you can use like a vortex such as, who is a vortex in here? Such as Tag Team Ichigo, you can use a vortex in single player and stun the boss or stagger him for a certain amount of time. But in co-op, that feature is gone. So using vortexes is only good to protect yourself. Keep in mind that even though you can see your teammates, even though you can see the enemies, those enemies and teammates can be around the entire map. Like, you don't know exactly where your teammates are. Thankfully, heals and buffs are completely room-wide, so you don't have to worry about, oh, is my teammate near me or anything like that. So that's also a good thing if you want to play a healer. Healers are definitely good in this game because you can actually stay away from the action and still be somewhat relevant. As a newer player, you might not want to be you might not want to spend orbs on reviving. If it's a good, if it's an easy raid and you see that everyone else can carry you, I'm not saying go into a raid and get carried, but please do your best. If I know that a person joins and is gonna die, and I think that they're gonna die, and they die and they don't even revive, and they don't care, they don't say sorry, they don't do anything, if I know that they're going for a carry, I will gladly disconnect in the final room, and you're not getting shit. It's simple. Like, if you're gonna die, if you know you're gonna die, or have an idea, or think that you're gonna die, and you're not playing a healer, or you're not doing any sort of support, you're not taking out enemies, just leave the room. And I'm not trying to say that in an elitist way. I'm saying that in a, you shouldn't be in this raid to begin with. Like, not in a bad way, but a lot of people see a recommended level at 120. If you're level 120, you still shouldn't be doing these raids. You should at least be 150. You should at least fill out your soul tree to about 90% for 6 stars. For getting a character from 5 star to 6 star is not very difficult. I understand that getting skills is quite difficult, but for that I highly recommend that you check out the Discord, ask around. More often than not, people are willing to help you or even carry you at some times. 4-star raids are relatively easy, even though they say recommended at 100. I still recommend that you're level at least 120 with at least a 90% soul tree, just so that the raid is a bit easier. I highly recommend that you do not bring characters that you have attribute disadvantage to. So as a newer player, I would advise against bringing a mind character to a heart raid and bringing a heart character to a mind raid. Keep in mind, heart is purple, mind is orange, power is red, speed is blue, and technique is green. And there's the green. So that's enough for raids. Raids is pretty self-explanatory. You do them to get raid material. The raid points is always good. Keep in mind that single player is definitely easier than co-op. Co-op just provides a lot of bosses, which means a higher chance of getting a drop. Now, Shadow Frenzy. Frenzy characters do have dual soul traits, which can be incredibly useful, especially for newer players. I highly recommend that you farm, say this Yoruichi right now. Like, her soul trait is strong attack damage 16% and strong attack recharge 11%, which is actually incredibly good. Usually frenzy characters as characters themselves are relatively bad. They're literally meant to be soul traits. They're usable, they're pretty cool, but I highly advise that you use them only as soul traits. I never really liked seeing frenzy Toshiros or Byakuyas or Yoruichis in my parties. It is what it is. Like, their stats just don't line up, you know what I mean? They're free to play character. Okay, so moving on, for frenzy events, I highly recommend that you at least get them to 150, max out their soul trait. I wouldn't really advise getting them to 200 unless you really, really want to. It's not really necessary. The only time level 200 is necessary is, or wanted, I mean, is if you max out link slots, and link slots, I know, they're a pain in the ass to farm. Enriched Droplet Zone, even though they say recommended level, I still highly recommend that you're at least level 150 for expert, at least level 150 for Legend and at least level 200 for Extreme. It's really hard. It's relatively hard. I recommend that you use a character with the soul, with the killer advantage towards this event. So as of right now, the killer advantages that are most beneficial are Hollow and Soul Reaper. But it could change over time, you never know. Same Inheritance Zone, I highly advise doing co-op. I prefer single player for that. Alright, moving on. Alright, so Fusion Trials. Now, Fusion Trials go on every so often. This is the only place where you can reliably get books or powders. Books or powders are used to evolve 4-star accessories into 5-star accessories. Obviously, you need the proper attribute for them. If you're looking for books, I know that books are incredibly rare. I highly advise that you host the lobby instead of, what's the word I'm looking for? Instead of just joining. You're better off creating your own room. You get the bonus, and the bonus is usually a book with approximately 15 to 20% chance, which is actually really good odds considering back in the day it was trash. Coin trials, I'd advise staying away from coin trial. You're better off doing it with yourself, doing that by yourself, unless you're joining the coin trial with coin links. It'll be fine, but honestly, I just kind of stay away from that. Personally, I'd rather farm jewels and sell the excess. If I showed you my medium jewels, you'll see that I have a ton of medium jewels that I'll never use because I'm missing small jewels. All right, 13 court guard squads training. Now, someone actually asked me in all seriousness, why should we do this and this and that? And they're like, what's the point of training grounds? And I told him, I'm like, training grounds is for crystals and jewels. And he's like, no, co-op. And I'm like, co-op. And what he meant was this 13 court guard squads training and the visored attack and march of the Iron Cart. Guys, these story missions are a complete waste of time, straight up. And I highly advise you don't even bother with them. It's literally a waste of time. And that's about it for co-op. Inheritance Zone, I highly advise you're level 200. You bring characters with good DR, good equipment in general. And for Extreme Co-op, I still highly advise that you get a pre-made party. Don't go into random co-op rooms. Don't go into random matching for inheritance. Or like you're going to see a bunch of enriched droplet zones and whatnot. Right, enriched droplet zones. Don't do it in co-op, guys. Don't do it in random matching. I highly advise you go to the Bleach Brave Souls Reddit Discord or my Discord. We usually have people that are willing to do that kind of stuff. But that stuff's relatively difficult, so I understand why people don't want to do it. And I understand completely why people don't want to do it in random matching. It's not worth it. I guess I will leave the video there. I wanted to keep this relatively brief. I hope it's brief enough, to be honest. Keep in mind that all these raids have one-shot mechanics, so it could be relatively difficult for newer players. The older raids are easier than the newer raids. I'll leave it at that. But y'all know these guys. Grind on, catch me up, hit me up. Stay blessed, y'all. I wish y'all the best of luck in your future summons. And if y'all need any help and whatnot, feel free to ask. My Discord's always open. Link is in the description below. And I didn't want to touch on the orbs per random matching in the beginners. The beginner orbs, whenever you get matched with someone random for the first time, I don't want to touch on to that because that is a limited resource and that will eventually go away over time as the count gets older. So I will leave it at that. Like, comment, and subscribe if you're new. Let me know if this video helped you. I like doing these types of videos. They're relatively easy to do. They let me speak to an audience that honestly does need help. And I understand. I've been a beginner. I used to freaking bring a red character into blue raids because that's all I had back in the day, and it sucks. And back in the day we weren't restricted with the room requirements, and it's kind of scummy of me, but honestly, I didn't die. I had a boss killer. It was a boss killer. It was Toby Yume. And I try to make myself as useful as possible. I try to CC as much as I could, but there's only so much you can do. But I will leave the video there. Stay blessed, y'all. And I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.